Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. A very warm welcome to you all on behalf of Vatican Media, Vatican Radio, and all of my colleagues here at the Vatican Dicastery for Communication. My name is Francesca Merlo, and it is my pleasure to be providing the commentary for this live broadcast of Pope Francis's Angelus, today, Sunday, the 4th of August. The event is taking place in St. Peter's Square in the Vatican, and those of you watching on television will be able to see that pilgrims have filled the square despite the scorching temperatures, and they are waiting for Pope Francis to appear at the window. A very warm welcome to all of you, whether you're joining us via our Vatican News YouTube channel, via our various partner stations, EWTN TV English, Catholic Faith Network in America, Salt and Light Television, Radio Maria England, Shalom World Television, Atmadarshan Television, Catholic Television, Luminous Radio India, Radio Maria Papua New Guinea, and via any local or diocesan radio station around the world. And a very warm welcome to all of our friends from the Deaf Catholic Youth Initiative for the Americas, also known as DCYIA. Please visit our YouTube channel with translation in American Sign Language at vaticannews-asl. This broadcast is also available live right now on our Vatican Media audio app and Vatican News website, which you can access at www.vaticannews.va and on our Facebook page. We will begin at midday precisely, Rome time of course, so in a minute, at which point the Holy Father will appear from the window of the Apostolic Palace and address the pilgrims. He usually reads a catechesis, then prays the Angelus, and then he usually makes some sort of appeal at the end of the recitation of the Angelus prayer. Now we will be providing an English translation of the catechesis and of the appeals, should there be any, and I will of course not speak over the Angelus prayer. And that all comes later on. Meanwhile, we are just waiting for the Holy Father to appear at the window. It's the first weekend of August, and this month the Holy Father's schedule picks up as usual. He usually takes July off from audiences, for example, though his Angelus did continue. And as you can hear from the crowd, Pope Francis has appeared at the window of the Apostolic Palace, and we will wait for him to begin his catechesis.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buona domenica.
Dear brothers and sisters, buona domenica, happy Sunday.
Oggi il Vangelo ci parla di Gesù.
Today the Gospel tells us about Jesus, who after the miracle of the loaves and fishes, invites the crowds who are looking for him to reflect on what took place, to understand its meaning. They had eaten the food that was shared and seen how even with few resources, all had been fed and had their fill, thanks to the generosity and courage of a young man who made available what he had with others. The sign was clear. If everyone gives to others what they have, with God's help, even with little, everyone can have something. Never forget this. If everyone gives to others what they have, with God's help, even with little, everyone can have something. Never forget this. Instead, they did not understand. They mistook Jesus for some kind of magician and went back to look for him, hoping he would repeat the miracle as if it were magic. They were the protagonists of a fundamental experience in their journey, but they did not grasp its significance. Their attention focused only on the loaves and fishes, the actual material food that finished immediately. leaving them still hungry. They did not realize that this was only an instrument through which the Father, while satisfying their hunger, revealed something far more important to them. What did he reveal to them? The path of life that lasts forever, and the taste of bread that satisfies beyond any measure. The true bread, in short, was and is Jesus, his beloved Son made man, who came to share our poverty in order to lead us through it to the joy and gift of full communion with God and with our brothers and sisters. Material things do not give fullness to life. They're important, but they don't fill life. Only love can do that. And for this to happen, the path to take is that of charity, which keeps nothing for itself, but shares everything. Charity shares everything. Does it not happen this way also in our families? Let us think of parents who struggle all their lives to raise their children well and leave them something for the future. How beautiful when this message is understood and the children are grateful and in turn become supportive of each other like brothers and sisters. And how sad, on the other hand, when they fight over inheritance. I've seen many cases of this. It's sad. And perhaps they do not speak to each other for money. They don't speak to each other for years. The message of a father and a mother, their most precious legacy is not money, but the love with which they give their children everything they have, just as God does with us. And in this way, they teach us to love. Let us ask ourselves then, what kind of relationship do I have with material things? Am I a slave to them? Or do I use them freely as instruments to give and receive love? Am I able to say thank you to God and to my brothers and sisters for the gifts I have received? And do I know how to share them with others? May Mary, who gave Jesus her whole life, teach us to make everything an instrument of love.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus e benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini. Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus e benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus e benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Gentis.
Ut in efficiamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam, quae sumus Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, ut qui angelo annunciante, Christi Fili tu, incarnazione cognovim, per passionem eius et crucem, a resurrezione gloriam perducamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam dona eis Domine.
Et lux perpetua lucet eis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiuterium nostrum in nomine Domine.
Qui feci caelum et terra.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen.
And with that, we've heard the catechesis and the recitation of the Angelus prayer. Dear brothers and sisters, last Friday in Berk in Lebanon, the patriarch Stephen Douay was beatified. He guided the Maronite search from 1600 to the 1700s. It's a difficult period marked with persecution. He was always a witness of hope, always close to the people. Today, too, the people of Lebanon are suffering. I am thinking of the victims and the families of the victims of the explosion in the port of Beirut. I pray for justice and for the new beatified to intercede for this beloved country. A round of applause for the new beatified.
Seguo con preoccupazione.
I follow closely and with worry what is happening in the Middle East. I hope that the bloody and violent conflict ends soon. I pray for all the victims, but in particular for the innocent children. I express my closeness to the Drusa community in the Holy Land and to the people in Palestine, Israel, Lebanon, and let us not forget Myanmar. May we have the courage to pick up dialogue for a ceasefire in Gaza and for hostages to be released. May the people be helped with humanitarian war, with humanitarian aid.
Non aiutano a percorrere il cammino della giustizia, il cammino della pace.
We must pursue a journey of peace and justice.
Basta, fratelli e sorelle, basta.
Enough, brothers and sisters, enough. Do not drown out the voice of the God of peace, but let it be heard in the Middle East and in the whole world. War is a defeat. I also express my preoccupation for Venezuela, living a critical situation. I appeal to all parties to seek the truth, to avoid all kinds of violence, and I ask all those involved to have the good of the people at heart.
Tanto amata e venerata dai venezuelani. Nella preghiera del beato José Gregorio Hernández.
May the prayer of the blessed Hernández guide the Venezuelan people. I also express my closeness to the people of India, in particular in Kerala, who have been hit by torrential rains, which have caused the loss of lives, displaced people, and much damage. I invite you to join me in praying for all those who have lost their lives and all those who are afflicted by such calamities.
In alcuni paesi si celebra la festa del parroco.
Today, in some countries, we celebrate the feast of the parish priest. I express my closeness and gratitude to all of the parish priests who are so generous and who work for God and for the people. Let's give a round of applause to our parish priests.
Saluto voi, Romani, pellegrini dell'Italia.
I greet all of you Romans and pilgrims of Italy and of the world, in particular from the Czech Republic, the company of Saint Ursula.
Trafani e Siderno.
faithful from various parts of the country, the youth of San Vito dei Normanni, Saint Vito of the Normans, the parishioners of the Sacred Heart in Padova, Italy. And with joy I greet the participants of the first festival of Portugal currently taking place in Fatima. Dear young people, I see that the experience of World Youth Day in Lisbon last year continues to bear fruits, and I continue to pray for you, and please you do the same and pray for me. I wish you all a lovely Sunday, and please don't forget to pray for me. Buon pranzo, enjoy your lunch, and arrivederci, goodbye. And that concludes this live broadcast of Pope Francis's Angelus this Sunday, the 4th of August. Today we heard a reflection on the miracle of the loaves and the fishes, and we also heard many appeals, mainly for peace and stability in countries where there is war and unrest. Now, this event is available on our Vatican News YouTube channel and our Vatican News website, where you can also find summaries of the Holy Father's discourses and homilies, as well as reports on his main activities. And you can find that at www.vaticannews.va. Please do also take a look at our Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram pages. Whether you joined us via our Vatican News YouTube channel, via our various partner stations, EWTN Television English, Catholic Faith Network in America, Salt and Light Television, Radio Maria England, Shalom World Television, Atmadarshan Television, Catholic Television, Luminous Radio India, Radio Maria Papua New Guinea, or via any local or diocesan radio station around the world, thank you. And a special thank you goes to all of our friends from the Deaf Catholic Youth Initiative for the Americas, TCYIA. Please do visit our YouTube channel with translation in American Sign Language at vaticannews-asl. My name is Francesca Merlo, and it has been an absolute pleasure being with you today. Thank you very much, and until next time, Laudetur Jesus Christus, praised be Jesus Christ.